Right now I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to turn a photo into a pencil sketch inside of Photoshop. And it's just a few simple steps. So the first step is we want to duplicate this layer. So hit Control or Command J, we duplicate it once. I'm going to hide the background and we're just kind of preserving that as a good practice. I want to take the color away. So what we're going to do is to get the color away, we can just go under Image Adjustments and then we're just going to choose Desaturate. By the way, we can also use Command-Shift-U, that would be Control-Shift-U on Windows, and that will remove the color. Great. Let's copy that. Control-Command-J will give us a duplicate. Okay, now I want to make an invert of this. So we want to make it the opposite, so Control or Command-I will invert it. So what we have right now is two black and white layers, one on top of the other, and the difference is they're inverted. All right, so what we're going to do now is under normal, we're going to change to a different blend mode here. Now watch what happens if we use the color dodge blending mode. We could use linear dodge as well. Either one will work. Let's use color dodge. So right now they're canceling each other out and we're not seeing anything. Watch what happens if we make them different. So with the top layer selected, we're going to choose filter, blur. We're going to grab our Gaussian blur. Now when we do, immediately we're going to start to see our results. So if we go just a little bit, we can get this kind of etched look. We could go further. We can take it up, you know, it almost looks like it's photocopied. Or just kind of go in between the middle here and it starts to look like we're working with some kind of a pencil sketch. Now we can do different things with this. Let me put these two layers together and I'm just going to hit Control U. I'm just going to hit Control G, put them into a group, and we're going to show the background. Now, the reason I want to show you this is we could do things with color. You know, if we went into luminosity blending mode, we can show those colors from the original colors through there. So now it looks like we're working with colored pencils. Let's go back to our other one that we were working just to pass through, and I'll show you another option. Let's create a new layer on top. And if you wanted to change the color of this, let's change from normal to hue, and you know we could fill this with different colors. You know, we could try a greenish color. Alter option, we fill that with there, and we're going to change this mode to color. All right, so if we want to look at different ways of colorizing it, we're going to grab an adjustment layer and we can choose a solid color if we wanted. Let's choose this kind of a greenish, not too much saturation. And then if we change the blend mode to color, it shows that. Now there's another way we could work. Let me show you another option. We're going to go here and we're going to choose a gradient. So now we can choose a colored gradient over the top. And, you know, there's all kinds of different gradients in here. Let's grab something, I don't know, some legacy gradient. Let's do the rainbow colored gradient so we can really see this at work. And we click OK. Now, let's change this to color. And you might have seen this kind of effect in ads and stuff like that. And if we want to adjust it, we double click. We can change the angle of the gradient. And we can also grab the scale of the gradient. So if you want less colors, if we increase this scale, we're going to get just a little bit less. If we decrease it, you're going to see a lot more color. But let's increase it a little bit. Now, if you don't like that color, if we drag, look at this, we can literally drag on this gradient and change the color and find what we want. Maybe we want something more like that. Click OK. So let me know in the comments underneath what you'd like to see me teach next and what do you think of this technique. And by the way, if you're new, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. Smash the like button into dust. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.